How you doing, people? Welcome to Let's Get Stringing. Up for stringing today is a Yonex Percept 97D. It has a 18 by 20 string pattern. Pretty dense string pattern. I've demoed this racket before. It hits very sweet, but I believe this is on a heavier side for my abilities. Looking at the unstrung weight here is 320 gram unstrung, 97 square inch head size, and 31 millimeter balance. So without further ado, let me go ahead and get this string started. Client is using Solingo Hybrid G16L at 51 pounds. Oh, I got the Yonex logo facing up. With no pre-stretch, because this is a poly. I don't do pre-stretch on a poly. Okay, this racket has 8 grommets in the throat, so I'll be stringing from the head end.
There's nothing like Canada in the off season. Or as we call it, wander off season. Power off season.
Below 60 back in China. Tony Gwynn. I don't mind watching Tony.
What's going on in today's video?
Oh, it's causing a racket. Shout out.
We are both 4.5s. The other 5.0s are all like doubles, so some people fill in the single spot. So we were chosen to play. And yeah, Marvin is just my complete opposite. He mostly plays doubles now, but when he plays singles, it is chaotic for me because he is so good. See that in the video. Pretty much this was literally 2 days after my tournament that I played. If you haven't watched that, go watch it on my channel. So on that Saturday, when after the quarterfinals, I ended up going to pretty much falling on their floor, just like full body cramping for 5 minutes. My left quad just gave out again, and then my lower back started hurting. Cramping, so it was kind of a rough Saturday night. I was super angry, super tired. I took all of Sunday off, and Monday, when this match was being played, that was pretty much when.
Well, conditions are pretty tough out there this couple of days, man. I was playing in the low 90s, humidity like up in 60 some percent. It was brutal. Not sure where he is, but put it like that. 2 days in a row. Couldn't even do a third set. We had to do a 10-point tiebreaker set. 10-point tiebreaker yesterday. Did that with the one guy, and then today I lost it to another guy. And we played a 7-point tiebreaker in lieu of a third set. I want to say the score today was so lopsided, I tell you. I beat him easily 6-love. I gave him a bagel 6-love in the first set. And in the second set, I don't know what happened. I think because of the conditions, my stamina or energy level just couldn't keep up because I've used up too much energy in the first set, I guess. And so that allowed him to flip it around. The second set score was 6-1. Him beat me 6-1. Can you believe that? And then we played a 7-point tiebreaker in lieu of a third set, and he beat me 7-3 or 7-4 or something like that. So yeah, my game can be so lopsided. One set sure felt like it was a sure thing I could beat him today, but he eventually turned things around, so props to him. Yeah, I almost forgot to talk about this until I started watching this guy Tony playing. This guy's good. I'm 3-5 and he's playing like, I think he's a 4-5 or 5-0. He's playing against 5-0. It's amazing. So coming up for the 8th string, we're skipping the 8th grommet down at the throat. Same thing here at the top, skipping the 8th grommet both top and bottom. Good shot, Tony. Okay, and for the 9th string, we're skipping the 10th grommet hole, both top and bottom. So this racket has 8 and 10 skips, both top and bottom. I cut the string length just right with no waste at all. I have to buy another reel of 16L after this. After this string job, I only have half a string job of it left. It's not even long enough for the mains. I have to use that half set for the crosses. So this strong weight of this racket at 320 grams, the strong weight is gonna be like 336. And by the time you add over grip onto it, it's gonna be over 340. That's why I couldn't. This is something that'll be too heavy for me to use. Customer is, I believe he plays on his high school team. He's a pretty tall kid, so I'm sure he has no problem with it. Starting my crosses from the 12th grommet hole for my third cross string. lost the first set 6-1. Off this first string. Oh, Tony's up 2-love. It's pretty tight, but still gonna go ahead and use it. Good hustle, Tony. Good hustle. So I came home an hour ago from playing. I was taking a bath and I found a cut on the side of my palm, you see. It's pretty deep and I'm afraid to pry it open. So it seems like, and I was trying to understand like how the hell I cut myself. There's nothing ever, you know, no sharp objects around while I was playing tennis. And then my guess would be as I open up a new can of tennis balls, you know how the aluminum or whatever metal that it's made of, the lid, once you pop it open, it's so easy to slice your skin open. I've done that a couple of times. One time I sliced one of my fingers open and I had to like quickly tape myself up on the court. And I got my overgrip all full of blood, like dirty, full of blood stains. And then I got some on the ball. It was a nasty tennis match. And then this guy who I played against on another occasion, he sliced his finger open. And he didn't have tape on him. Luckily, I had a roll of tape. So I had to help him, I had to give him some for him to tape up his fingers in order to keep playing. So in my opinion, with the technology these days, I would think that these ball makers would come up with some other way to seal these cans closed, you know, and then while keeping them the ball pressurized until they're ready to be open. What do you think? I'm not such a smart guy, but I would hope that they will come up with some alternative way of doing this. So if you have an opinion or any idea on how they should make tennis ball cans differently, please let me know. That would prevent some on-court injuries. Whew. Luckily, I didn't cut it deep enough today that it started bleeding on the court. I mean, I didn't even notice it on the court until I came home. That was kind of weird. Trailing now, the other guy won four matches in a row. Tony's trailing 2-4. The other guy is about to win another game, so now it's 2-5. Tough match. Wow. Just burned my finger with that. I'm pulling too fast. Such an unlucky day, man. Injury prone day.
Yeah.
Injury prone. String bed is definitely dense. It's even difficult to pull the strings through. You'll get him next time, Arvin. I mean, Tony. Keep at it.
Well, just because I'm not used to it, so you know, I feel like if I'm always trying something new, watching. Make sure to hit like and subscribe for some more content. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye.
The dude, Carew again. I thought I've seen this match already. Played again 12 days ago. Wow. Played quite often. Often these guys. I did see this video. It seemed longer than that, but so it's only been 12 days. Some tennis highlights, grass court highlights. Racket reviews. Nothing that interesting. All right, some talk shows and politics stuff. Whatever.
现在要持续关注政治局势，在今天呢。
One, two strings left. Cut it a little bit long. It's okay. A little bit long is better than a little bit short.
越南也有兴趣啊，海上资源的区域啊，越南没兴趣啊，马来西亚没兴趣啊，印尼啊，不
All right, thank you very much for watching. Take it easy.